Hello. Yeah, let us look at the problems it given to you. Define linearly dependent and independent vectors. So what are linearly dependent and independent vectors? When we consider the vectors x, y, z, and let us say a, b, c are scalar real values, then the linear combination of x, y, z is ax plus by plus cz. Now, if we can write ax plus by plus cz equal to 0 for the values of a comma b comma c not equal to 0, then we call the vectors x, y, z as linearly dependent vectors. Otherwise, they are called as linearly independent vectors. Now, what is the significance of this practically? Now, you have these vectors linearly dependent. It means that these vectors stay in the same plane. I'm repeating. If we can write x comma y comma z as linearly dependent vectors, then these vectors x, y, z, they lie in the same plane of dimensionality n by 1, of course. Now, let's move to the next one. Orthogonal vectors and orthonormal vectors. If the dot product of the vectors is 0, then the vectors are called orthogonal vectors. If the dot product, let us say there are two vectors x and y. If x dot y is equal to 0, obviously y dot x will also be equal to 0. In that case, it is said that x and y are orthogonal to each other. Now, if these orthogonal vectors are also unit vectors, then they are called as orthonormal vectors. What is the procedure you remember to convert orthogonal vectors into orthonormal vectors? Yes, it is Gram-Smith procedure. Next, compute the inner product and outer product of the columns of identity matrix. What is identity matrix? Let us consider a 3 by 3 identity matrix. The first column is 1 0 0, second column 0 1 0, third column 0 0 1. Now let us call these vectors as C1, C2, C3. C1 is 1 0 0, C2 is 0 1 1, 0 1 0, C3 is 0 0 1. Now the dot product or inner product of the first vector with itself is C1 star transpose multiplied with C1, which is equal to 1 0 0 the row vector multiplied with the column vector 1 0 0. So it is 1 into 1 plus 0 plus 0, 1 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 0 into 0, which gives me 1. So C1 is a unit vector. Let us see C1 dot product with C2. Or inner product with C2. So C1 star transpose multiplied with C2 is nothing but 1 0 0 the row vector multiplied with 0 1 0 the column vector. So 1 into 0 0, 0 into 1 0, 0 into 0 0. So 0 plus 0 plus 0 is 0. So the dot product of C1 with C2 is 0. Hence we can say that C1 is orthogonal to C2 and C2 is also orthogonal to C1. You know, C1, the dot product of C1 and C2 will be equal to the dot product of C2 and C1. It is commutative. Now, we can similarly see that the dot product of C1 with C3 is also equal to 0. So, we can similarly compute the other dot products and we can observe that C1 dot product with C1 is equal to 1. Hence, the length of the vector C1 is equal to 1. So, it is a unit vector. While the dot product of C1 with the other vectors is equal to 0. So, C1 is orthogonal to C2 and C3. C1 is a unit vector. So, the column vectors of C1, the column vectors of identity matrix are orthonormal vectors. Now, what is an outer product? Outer product, inner product, we can see that this is a row vector multiplied with a column vector. The size of this is 3 by 1 and the size of this is 1 by 3. So the result, one second, the size of this is 1 by 3 and the size of this is 3 by 1. So the resultant is 1 by 1, which is a scalar value. Now the outer product, this is a 3 by 1 vector and this is a 1 by 3 vector. So the resultant will be a 3 by 3 matrix. So 1 into 1 is 1, 1 into 0 is 0, right? 1 into 0 is 0. Now 0 into 1, 0, 0 into 0, 0, 0 into 0, 0, 0 into 0, 0 into 1, 0, 0 into 0, 0, 0 into 0, 0. So this is what we have. Now C1 into C2 star transpose is 100 multiplied with 010. This will give us 010000000. Similarly, we can compute the remaining dot products. Okay, so these matrices that you see have very important significance that we will see in near future. So here one interesting thing you can see, C1 C2 star transpose is this matrix, while C2 C1 star transpose, which is the outer product, is this matrix, and these two are not equal. Hence, the outer product will not commute. It will not obey the commutative property. The inner product will always result in a scalar value, and the outer product will always result in a matrix. What is row space and what is column space of a matrix? The span. What is meant by a span? Set of all possible linear combinations. So the span of rows of matrix A is called row space of A. So it is nothing but if you take the linear combination of the rows of A, all possible such linear combinations will make a plane, and that plane is called as row space of A, column space or range of A. The span of columns of the matrix capital A is called as column space or range of A. This is very important. Now define what is rank of a matrix. The rank of a matrix is nothing but number of independent rows or columns in a matrix. I'm repeating, the number of independent rows, which is also equal to the number of independent columns in a matrix, is called as rank of the matrix. What is transpose of a matrix? Transpose of a matrix is obtained by interchanging the rows and columns. I'll make the rows as columns and the columns as rows. 1, 2, 1 is the first row. This will become first column of A transpose. 3, 0, minus 2 will be the second column of the matrix A transpose. Similarly, the third row will be the third column. Okay, this is represented by A transpose. It is called A transpose. What is a symmetric matrix? A symmetric matrix, you know, is a matrix. When we have A equal to A transpose, if the matrix is equal to its own transpose, then we call that matrix as a symmetric matrix. Next. So there is an example I have given here. You can check it by yourself. 1, 2, 3 is the first row. 1, 2, 3 is the first row, which is also equal to the first column 1, 2, 3. 2, 0, 2 is the second row, which is also equal to the second column 202. 321 is the third row, which is equal to the third column 321. So it is a symmetric matrix. Next, there's a matrix given to us and we are asked to verify the matrix, you know, we are asked to find out the transpose of the matrix, conjugate of the matrix, conjugate transpose or Hermitian of the matrix. Transpose of the matrix is obtained by interchanging the rows and columns. Conjugate of the matrix is obtained by replacing each element in the matrix with the conjugate of that element. Conjugate transpose of the matrix is obtained by finding out the conjugate and then transposing the matrix. Now let us consider the matrix capital A. The matrix capital A is this. The transpose is obtained by interchanging the rows and columns, and the transpose of the matrix is this. The conjugate of the matrix is obtained by simply taking each element in the matrix and replacing it with its conjugate. J will be replaced by minus J. 1 will remain same because it's a real value. 2 minus J is going to replace with 2 plus J. So on. That will result in this matrix. A star transpose is conjugate transpose of the matrix, which is also called as Hermitian of the matrix. So this is obtained by either conjugate the matrix A transpose, or transpose the matrix A star, which is the conjugate matrix. So if you do that, this is the resultant. Next, what is a Hermitian matrix? A matrix is called as Hermitian matrix if the matrix is equal to the Hermitian of the matrix. So we can see A is equal to this 1 minus J, J1. A star is 1, replacing minus J with J, replacing J with minus J, and 1 will remain same as 1. A star transpose is the transpose of this matrix, which is also equal to A itself. So A equal to A star transpose, hence it is called as Hermitian matrix. Now, what is an orthogonal matrix? What is a unitary matrix? And what is orthogonal matrix is a matrix which satisfies this following equation. A into A transpose equal to A transpose into A equal to I. So if I multiply the matrix with its own transpose, then it should result in the identity matrix. What is meant by unitary matrix? A unitary matrix is a matrix which satisfies A into A star transpose equal to A star transpose into A, which is equal to I. So if the matrix is multiplied with the conjugate transpose of the matrix, then it should result in the identity matrix. So when the orthogonal matrix will become a unitary matrix, or it is other way, when a unitary matrix will become orthogonal matrix, if the unitary matrix is a real matrix, then it is also an orthogonal matrix. If a matrix is orthogonal matrix, it always need not be a unitary matrix. And again, if a matrix is unitary matrix, it always need not be an orthogonal matrix, except if it is a real matrix. Now, it is asked to find out whether A1, A2, A3, they are orthogonal or unitary. It can be obtained by finding out A into A star transpose and A into A transpose for each of the matrix A1, A2 and A3. I am leaving this to the next session.